Bradley Powell, and I'm a student at University of Louisiana in Lafayette.
Aloha. I am Mel, and I live and work, play, and knit here on the island of Kauai.
Hi, my name is Amy, and I'm a graphic designer. This is my husband, Darren.
I'm also a graphic designer, and I sell advertising in an automotive classified.
And we are from the Mississippi Gulf Coast, right on the Gulf of Mexico, about an hour east of New Orleans.
Hi, I'm Heather Monroe Kinney. I am the owner of Highland Handmaids, which is a small internet-based yarn and fiber shop. And I also host a knitting podcast called The Fiber East Files, although, disclaimer, some episodes are not intended for younger viewers.
I'm Mandy Shoemaker, and I'm a stay-at-home mom.
Hey, I am Fiona. I am in Cairns, which is in tropical North Queensland in Australia.
What do you have to say to people who think knitting's just a hobby that people do?
Yeah, they have no idea.
Knitting, to me, is an act of creation. From the first vague idea that I get of a design floating in the periphery of my mind to dyeing or spinning exactly the right yarn, to selecting the correct needles, to knit those first stitches, knitting is a tangible act of intention. I love that when the knitting is done, I'm left with a physical item that exists because from start to finish, I created it. And in our increasingly complex world, the makers of things are harder to find and I think are less valued. And knitting then, to me, becomes an act of subversion, and I like that. And if nothing else, then I have a post-apocalyptic skill set that the bankers, investors, and tech people of the world don't have. And who's going to be more valuable then?
Knitting is an escape and a release and an outlet for creativity.
What is knitting to me? Knitting is a tool. Knitting is a means for what I have in here that swirls around and has to be created. It's a way for that to come through and out and present itself in a way that has texture and movement. I was a dance teacher for many years and love movement. Love the way that you can hear something or take something in and then through choreography express that. And so in some respects, knitting to me is a way to dance through my hands and with some really interesting textiles.
To me, knitting is a hobby that has kind of taken over my life, pretty much. I really enjoy having something to do, like when I'm sitting down watching TV or listening to a podcast or an audiobook, and it's really great. It's really wonderful. Really enjoy it.
To me, knitting is, on one hand, it's something to, I'm a fiddler, I fidget a lot, so knitting is something to do with my hands, but it's more than that, it's soothing, it's calming when I get angry or upset or in any way, then knitting calms me down, and it's something, like, it's just a way to paint things, because I can't paint, I can't draw, I can't do any of that, so it's a creative outlet.
For me, knitting is a very creative outlet. With all of the hobbies that I've had, I've done scrapbooking in the past. I like being able to sort of have something to show for the time that I put into something. And for knitting, it's really worked out really well. I have a whole cabinet full of stuff that I've produced.
It's become an obsession.
Knitting is using different techniques to join, to get yarn, to twist together, to create a beautiful fabric. Knitting is a process, and it's also an output. So it's something I can do with my hands, but also something that I can wear afterwards.
All right. Did you ever think that knitting would impact your life this much?
No, not at all. Not at all. I have a huge different group of friends. I have an entirely different life than I had without it. So.
Do you ever think that knitting would impact your life this much?
Definitely not. If someone would have told me that I was going to have met so many people and traveled to so many different places and have yarn and spinning wheels and a podcast even, I probably would have laughed at them.
I would say the same thing. I had no idea this would completely take over both of our lives and space in our house. But it's been great. It's been wonderful to meet so many people and have something that we can both do together that we enjoy.
Yeah, it's been really nice.
I had no idea that knitting would become as big a part of my life as it has. Knitting was a gateway drug that led me to designing patterns, to learning to spin, to dyeing yarn and fiber, and then to opening my own business, and then to making it my day job. It has quite literally taken over my life. It is the first thing I think about when I wake up. It is what I work on all day long, and it is the last thing I think about as I fall asleep.
No, I never thought that there would be a point in my life where I was almost never without a pair of needles in my bag at all times. I'm almost always doing it if I'm just sitting anywhere.
I knew right away that knitting was a lifeline, a life preserver for me in a time where I had deep feelings of melancholy and quite a bit of despair just being bedridden during a long, hard pregnancy. So right away, it gave me an outlet for creativity and for thinking and for being productive. Since that time, it has given me amazing gifts, not just from myself, but from others. From others, I've gotten friendship and opportunities to travel and visit and be in touch with really amazing people. From myself, I've gotten quite a bit of confidence and resolve. It just permeates so much of my life, it's hard to compartmentalize. I am excited to create, I'm excited to learn. So knitting has given me many different venues to see its benefits. And so, yes, I knew that it was a lifeline early on, and it continues to be, even now.
The community around knitting is amazing. I think the yarn harlot has always said knitters are awesome, and she's right. Yes, we're all human, but at the same time, knitters have a different way of looking at things. I think it's part of the way that our craft, we have to solve problems, and things, you can fudge things at times if your stitch count isn't working out. But at the same time, sometimes you do have to just rip back and redo things. And I think that creates a mentality or a mindset in knitters that means you can always look at life differently. I've met some amazing people. I watch podcasts. I'm involved in the podcasting community. I've got my own podcast. And just the sharing of knowledge and the way people are willing to help each other is pretty amazing.
What is the community around knitting like?
Very accepting of just everyone. There's so many people in my knitting community that are different races, genders, creeds, you know, and everybody's very respectful, and it's all about the art more than the person.
Knitting and the knitting community has really helped me find my people. I was a teacher for 9 years. It's what I went to school for. I was a high school English teacher. And while I loved the work I was doing, there was never a school district that felt even a fraction as welcoming as the knitting community does. With knitters, I'm able to be completely myself with no judgments about the fact that I have a tongue ring or I love pickup trucks or I don't want to have children or I like Dropkick Murphys or any of a thousand things that in more conventional communities would label me as different. In the knitting community, we're all bound together by our love of yarn and fiber and the craft. And in that instance, we're not different. There are no outliers. We're all the same. And I really love that.
There's not a huge knitting community around here. I found a couple of groups here and there, but for us, it's mostly been about going places and right. meeting people. And usually that means traveling. We've traveled, and most of our friends we've met online.
Right, the festivals and things like that, the retreats. It's really been fun to meet different people and connect over something that you both enjoy. It's been really, really amazing. I had no idea we'd meet so many people with this hobby.
Yeah, and also when we traveled to Portland and Seattle recently, I was really shocked at the number of yarn stores that they had. And unfortunately, we only had time to go to a few, but I think it would be amazing to live someplace where there's such a large community that it can sustain so many yarn stores.
And I hope you guys understand that knitting isn't just for older women who want something for their grandchildren. It's something that everyone can do, and no one should ever be discouraged from doing it because it has a bad stigma that it's not okay to do it because I'm a boy or I'm a teenager and teenagers don't do this, because teenagers don't do a lot of stuff, but then there's always those few that do, and it just opens your eyes to what life's about. Remember, you're living for yourself, you're not living for anyone else. You don't owe anyone any explanations. I just wanted to let you guys know why I did this documentary, and it's to show you that knitting is something far greater than what you guys have ever thought of it as. And I hope you guys have understood that, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you. Electric song. Will you still love me?